Pod to ponjavo tukaj spodaj se skriva zelo velika zgodba. Ampak velika zgodba ni v tem, da je C3 postal mali SUV. Pa tudi ni v tem, da je C3 postal EC3, se pravi električni avtomobil. Velika zgodba je v tem, da je ta avtomobil zgrajen na povsem novi Stellantisovi platformi za električna vozila. Ampak posebnost je v tem, da ta platforma temelji na litij-železo-fosfatnih baterijah. In te so res revolucionarne. Dajmo, odgrnimo ga, pa poglejmo, zakaj gre.
Citroën has a legacy of always solving the problems of people and society. Forget everything you know about electric cars.
We are a brand that dares.
People want to go electric, people need to go electric, but they can't always do it.
Torej, Citroën z novim EC3 elektrificira družbo s poceni avtomobilom. 23.300 evrov je seveda prevedeno na slovensko plačo še vedno absolutno veliko, a širše gledano to vseeno pomeni, da je EC3 relativno poceni avtomobil. Necenen nizkocenovec, narejen ne za prodajo v nekdanjih francoskih kolonijah, to je avto za Evropo.
This is a fully designed and built in Europe car.
Inspiracija pa so bili poceni kitajski električni avtomobili.
Every month you see more and more Chinese car because obviously they are attractive for customers because they are very very affordable. So this is why we need to fight with the same weapons as they have, which is the production cost.
This is our technical and cost reference. A car that is built 25% faster than the previous C3.
Ključnega pomena so litij, železo, fosfatne baterije.
10 years ago nobody was talking about LFP and now it's coming and it's great. So that's why we are very happy to be the first one to have a LFP battery.
Litij, železo, fosfatne baterije omogočajo, da jih lahko redno polnimo na hitrih polnilnicah. Lahko jih tudi redno polnimo do 100%, pa se zaradi tega ne bodo prehitro postarale. To uporabo električnega avtomobila približuje tudi tistim brez lastne domače garaže z lastno domačo počasno polnilnico, na kateri polnimo čez noč. Ker pa je pri električnih avtomobilih glavni strošek baterija, se je Citroën za LFP baterije odločil predvsem zaradi nizkocenovnosti avtomobila.
Nitrat it's costly at the end of the day. And when you have low nitrats, it's a low cost for the battery. LFP it's a low nitrats, more robust. And thanks to that, at the end of the day, it's a cost saving for customers.
Koncern Stellantis je pri uvajanju novih tehnologij vedno precej zadržan in zato bo tudi ta EC3, čeprav popolnoma optimiziran za električni pogon, na voljo tudi z bencinskim motorjem. Ampak...
I would not be surprised if we sell half electric and half petrol, because frankly, the car is so attractive in terms of price that you will have probably a lot of people who say who never think of going electric but then they will go electric.
No, pa poglejmo kaj dobimo za nizko ceno.
EC3 comes with a range up to 320 km WLTP with fast charging from 20 to 80% in 26 minutes thanks to a 100 kilowatt DC and a very brand new efficient trip planner called eRoutes with the best algorithm on the market. Why an SUV attitude? Just because it has evident customer benefits and customer value. Easier egress and egress, roominess for both front and rear occupants, and also a generous boot volume. All that is just a 4.01-meter car, which is exactly the same footprint as the current C3.
Kako pa so svojo drznost dokazali oblikovalci?
Is that we have the three signature dots, the two horizontal bars and then the big vertical one. It's a very homogenic design that on the rear and the front you have the same kind of signatures that will distinguish all the future Citroëns and will be very iconic in the night and in the street because no other car actually has this kind of light signature.
No, zdaj imamo tudi v Citroënu majhen volan in pa merilnike, ki so nameščeni zelo visoko, se pravi, da podatek o hitrosti gledamo nad merilniki, ne pa skozi, kot smo bili doslej navajeni. Se pravi, Tukaj imamo nekakšno Citroenovo različico Peugeotovega iCockpita.
Alfa Romeo has to be dynamic, sexy, sporty. Our cars have to be sexy as well, but not dynamic and not not sporty. So I send my designers to the Fnac. You know the Fnac? To electronic stores. So I send the designers to MediaMart to design the front face, to design the interior, to have an influence that is not automotive.
We love it. It's a Citroën head-up display. What it is, it's a reflected screen that is actually horizontal, reflected on a dark blade, and actually only the graphic information come out.
Of course, a cluster that you would have just like that would be cheaper, but it would be more boring as well. So here we have a screen that we had to push a little bit in intensity because it's reflected on a piece that is darker. Yeah. So it's a little more expensive, but it was the right choice for the car because you only have one level for the for all the cars. It's different, it's more intuitive, it's in the right place.
Sicer lahko poročam že zdaj, da se v tem avtomobilu počutimo kot bolj, v bolj prostornem avtomobilu, čeprav gre za zelo majhen avtomobil. In ja, sej se pozna, da je kar veliko plastičnih delov, ampak nekako so vse skupaj citrojenovci zapakirali tako kot znajo, da vse skupaj izpade bolj igrivo, simpatično, se pravi citrojenovsko.
You know, a couple years ago, when you would develop a car, if the material that is recycled costs more money, we would say no. Today, it's a must. So we start with recycled materials. Now, sometimes, you know, it's in the most boring places. It's, you know, the black plastic are recycled. And it's easy to get scraps from plastic. You re-inject it, and you control the black color. It would be difficult to have a white plastic recycled.
In design-wise, there's nothing that we had to compromise. The compromise always happens in details, in small details that aren't necessary and hopefully not at all visible to the customer. For example, I can tell you that this piece here is not painted. It's not glossy black painted, but it's molded in color. It's much cheaper and it's better for the ecology as well. It's better for the environment not to paint it. It's one example of where we have different elements of the car that help us to lower the price, but we have this no compromise in terms of styling and design.
With a little tool, you'll be able to remove these, yeah? And let's say for the next European Football World Cup,
yeah.
I want to put the French flag, and et voilà.
That's okay. That looks great. But people listen to us from every country in the world, so I'm sure that they will put their own flag.
Absolutely.
Električni C3 svojo SUV-jsko obliko seveda pomeni povsem drugačna zgodba, kot pa so jo povedali predhodniki modela C3, se pravi prababica, babica in pa mamica. Ampak nekaj pa zagotovo ostaja. C3 bo tudi v električni dobi pomenil izredno pomemben model za Citroën.
The C3 is today, it's 40% of our passenger car sales. I exclude the light commercial vehicles, but it's 40% of our sales.
Glede na to, da je zdaj že osnovni C3 mali SUV, se seveda poraja vprašanje, kaj bo s C3 Aircrossom. In zdaj se na nek način v ponudbo spet vrača Picasso. V naslednjih sekundah namreč bodite pozorni na število sedežev.
And we would like to show you the very first images of our future B-SUV.
As you can see, the surprise on the, perhaps I call it the replacing of the new C3 Aircross. And to have in mind, these two cars will be developed in the same time. In reason one, when we have cost efficiency on this car, it will be as we know,
Citroën je EC3 predstavil v hangarju Y v Meudonu pri Parizu. Ta hangar je bil leta 1884 prizorišče prvega krožnega poleta z zračno ladjo. Seveda, za razcvet zračnih ladij je pozneje poskrbel grof Zeppelin iz Friedrichshafna ob Bodemskem jezeru. Pa naj se zdaj vaš naslednji klik prisluži prav naš obisk v Cepelinovem hangarju.